For any positive integer n, the sum of the first n positive integers is equal to n n plus 1 divided by 2. That means what we have been given is that sigma n, which is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n, is 1 upon 2 times n into n plus 1. It's a generalized standard formula that we should also remember, because we can use it in any question where we have to add the sum of n consecutive positive integers. What is the sum of all even integers between 99 and 301? Now, there are two ways we can answer this question. One, by using this particular method. Second, without using this method. I'll find to answer this question without using this formula. So I'll quickly discuss with you that other method first. So let me write it as method number one. So method number one is simply based on the principle of arithmetic progression, in which what we find is that in any arithmetic progression in which the terms are equally spaced, the sum of n terms can be represented as n by 2 first term plus the last term. The reason is that the sum of the first and last term will be same as sum of second and second last in any arithmetic progression, and so on. And if there are n terms, then there will be n by 2 pairs. So this gives us sum of n terms. What we need to find out here is sum of all the even integers between 99 and 301. So we have to just calculate 100 plus 102 plus 104 plus and so on. It has to go till 300. Now, so there is only one question that we have right now, that how many terms do we have here? That means what is the value of n? Then understand that from 1 to 300, the total even numbers is 300 divided by 2, that means 150. And we have to avoid counting all the even numbers from 1 to 98, because after 98 the next even number is 100, which we need to count. So 1 to 98 there are half even numbers, that means 49. So the number of terms that we have here will be equal to 101. So now that we have the number of terms, we can simply use the property 101 divided by 2. The first term is 100, the last term is 300, that means the sum is going to be 101 divided by 2 times 400, which means 101 times 200, that means 202 followed by 2 zeros. It was quite simple, and that's the answer, which is option B. Now, we can also learn it using method 2. Now, in method 2, we are going to use the property that we have been given, which is sum of n consecutive numbers. So what we need to do first here is we need to write the series that we have to add. That means the given series is 100 plus 101, 102 plus 104 plus and so on. It has to go up to 300. Alright. So now if you take 2 common from this entire sequence, what we are left with is 50 plus 51 plus 52. Right? Because 102 divided by 2 is 51, 104 divided by 2 is 52, and so on. This has to go up to 150. Now what we can do here is that we have 2 out here. Now from a series that is the sum of from 1 to 150, if we subtract the sum from 1 to 49, then we will be left with the same series, because after 49 we have 50 onward terms. Now we can use this property, sum of 1 to 150 is 1 upon 2 times 150 times 151 minus sum of 1 to 49 is 1 by 2, 49 times 50. We can take 1 by 2 out, so 2 times 1 by 2, in the bracket we have 150 into 151 into 151 minus 49 into 50. Now it's only the matter of some calculations, and the final result we have once again get is 202 00. Once again we have option B as our correct answer, right? So I recommend personally that learning this basic, that sum of n terms in any arithmetic progression is n by 2 first term plus last term, is more important and better way to answer such question. Let me just quickly explain this once again, that if I have a series like any arithmetic progression, let's say 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11. And you see the sum of first and last term is 1 plus 11, 12. Second and second last term is 3 plus 9, 12. 5 plus 7 is 12. So that way, if you need to find out the sum, so we have 6 terms, so 6 by 2 pairs, every pair has sum which is 1 plus 11. That's where this property comes from. I hope you enjoyed the explanation. Thank you so much.